We are very pleased to be joined by NASA's GOES-S Launch Manager and a member of the Kennedy Space Center Launch Services Program, Tim Dunn. Congratulations, Tim.
Thank you so much, Mike. I'm glad to be here.
This was, it seemed to be a picture-perfect countdown.
Wow. This was smooth. They don't all come this way, but when they do, we truly appreciate them. Really, we did not say one word on the anomaly net the entire day, and so you like that. That's a good countdown.
And weather cooperated with you as well?
Gorgeous weather. Obviously, if you saw any of the outside shots here in the local Cape Canaveral area, you knew it was a Chamber of Commerce day. So really appreciate that. You may have heard some discussion on upper-level winds. That was really about the only thing that we were discussing. Had a little bit of a disturbance at about 45,000 feet that we had to just model correctly to ensure that Atlas V could smoothly fly through that regime and maintain its controllability. So once we got that well in hand, about the last half hour or so of the countdown, there was really nothing else to monitor other than an exceptional team, a tremendous team. I tell you, working with the United Launch Alliance team on Atlas V is a real pleasure. Watching the NASA Launch Services Program engineering team manage a countdown, watching what our chief engineer and his team do, seeing how our spacecraft customer from Goddard Space Flight Center, the GOES-S project and program, how they come and they integrate in for that last few months leading up to launch, and then to execute all that on launch day and to receive a tremendous range support that we get from the United States Air Force here at the 45th Space Wing. Just watching this multidiscipline team do its thing is just so rewarding to watch. I love it. I feel so honored to be a very small part of this team, and it's just a thrill, especially when it all ends in launch success and mission success for GOES-S and this cutting-edge weather capability that our nation will now have.
Yeah, all of what you said is very true. It is an amazing team of people that stretches across the country with United Launch Alliance and the NASA teams. How long has it has this launch? I guess this whole launch process been in for GOES-S? How long have you been working this launch?
Well, specific to GOES-S, we've been working about 15 months just on GOES-S, because 15 months ago we were here launching GOES-R,
right,
its predecessor, which is now on orbit and providing great weather data for our use. So kind of GOES-R and S together has been a multi-year development that's been in work for probably about the past 5 to 7 years. So all of that, there's a lot of work that goes in to a launch day like this.
Will you be our NASA launch manager when we come around to GOES-T?
We're not sure. Looking forward to GOES-T. Looks like that's going to be in a couple of years in 2020. And Omar Baez, our other program launch director, and I, we sort of flip coins and decide who does which launch. If it's my turn, I'd be honored to do it. Omar would likewise.
Okay. Well, this is going to be a great process watching that all develop, and of course, we'll be standing by for the solar array deploy on GOES-S.
Yes.
The beginning of about a 22-day timeline as it gets ready to get into action, but
right
up until this point, it's just been a terrific launch campaign.
Right. So I'll just say for a moment, this is a huge year for Launch Services Program. This is the first of 6 launches that our program has this year, so a very busy year for us, working from both coasts here at the Cape and as well as Vandenberg, and then downrange in the Pacific at Quaj. So Pegasus will fly a payload for us. Our first flight on the Delta IV Heavy vehicle, go out to Vandenberg and do another Atlas from Vandenberg with a Mars mission from the west coast of the United States. We've never gone interplanetary from the west coast. That's going to be a thrill. And we're launching a Falcon 9 here from the Cape with SpaceX just next month in April. And then one that's a little close to my heart, the very final Delta II will launch this year from Vandenberg, carrying the ISAT II mission. So
I recall that is, you're very fond of Delta II.
I am fond. I love Atlas V. I love them all, but Delta II will always have a special place in my heart.
I remember you talking about you can't just love one of your children, but but you do love all of your children, but you
love
have a special place in your heart for the Delta II. Well, thank you again for stopping by, Tim, and congratulations again today on such the culmination of a wonderful launch campaign.
Yes.
And a beautiful launch of GOES-S.
Great. Thank you, Mike.
You bet. Thank you.